Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, consider subscribing, clicking like on this video. And if you are returning, thank you as well. Today we're revisiting the mass text feature in Adobe Express. A while back I shared how to create this graphic using your photos in a background, but today we're going to be using colors in the background instead. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of express.adobe.com, and I'll start by clicking on the plus sign and choose a custom size graphic. And for this one, I'm just going to sort through the different sizes. I'm gonna go ahead and go with a Facebook size or a horizontal landscape formatted size. I'm gonna go ahead and name my project mask text colors, because we're going to be using colors for this project here. The first thing that I'm going to do is for this background is lay out a cell or a grid here. And there's so many different options. If you click on the layout menu here, you see all these different options. Depending on how many layers or colors you want in the background, just choose the one you want. I'm going to go and go with this one right here with horizontal. And right now by default, the colors, if I click on the colors menu, it's showing current. I have my branded colors here, so I can click those and kind of click through here and choose the different ones, just rotate between or shuffle. You could also choose the different color palettes that are here. I'm going to go ahead and go with mine though for this example. And I'm just going to click through until I get to the colors that I want, and maybe I'll go with that one there. And I'm going to just slightly make some adjustments here to these colors. I want to bring the colors in, so it's okay that it's large here at the bottom and at the top. I want to actually be able to see all those colors. So now the next step is to click on text, and then I will add some text here. Let's go ahead and close this box out. And I'll go ahead and just for this example, type in my name, but you can put any word here. It doesn't matter the color right now at the moment. What I do though is choose a color, or I should say choose a font that is large and it is very substantial as far as when you can see the colors through it. So here's what I mean. So right now, as you notice, this font is fairly thick and I want that. Before I continue, I'm actually going to click on these colors just to bring this up a bit here, and I'll do the same for that just so the colors will show through here. So let's bring that down a bit. Let's click on this cell. And again, we'll click through. Pretty good there. And then what I'm going to do now is click on my text once more. And we're going to come down here to the menu option that says shape. So we'll click this drop down menu. As you can see, there is a shape for it. The color of the shape right now is this blue. I'm going to go ahead and choose white. And what we're going to do is for the shape, we'll click on this box right here. And you'll see all these different shapes that you can choose from. But we actually want to choose the fill. We want the entire place to be filled. And as you can see, pretty much has already done it right here with this mask option here. I'm going to show it to you. Right now it's not masked, but when I clicked on fill, it automatically masked and I can see right through. There's my colors in the background. Really cool feature. So I'm going to go ahead and show you a cool trick here. I'll click on this duplicate so I can have my project here showing. You'll see that there are two versions of it. So I'm going to come back down here and let's change this from Claudio. We can do some whatever word you are. I'm going to go ahead and type in create and then make this larger. So now we see more of the colors bleeding through, or you can see through. A really cool effect here. Now, if you want to, I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this once more. You can further make adjustments to that background. So let's go ahead and click on first the text here, and we're going to come back down here to the shape. We're going to turn it off for a second, because now what we're going to do is go back to this layout and we're going to go a lot more drastic on the background. We're going to, let's see here, let's choose this one right here. So now I've got more colors bleeding through or showing through. And again, I'll go into my colors, make some adjustments. So now we got more. Let's go ahead and go with this bold one right here. Cool. Okay, so now we got all these different colors. And again, I'm going to click on that right there just to make some adjustments to those colors here. We'll bring this in as much as I can. Let's see, let's go to layout. Maybe what we'll go is with a grid because it doesn't seem to want to cooperate. Let's go with this one right here. That one will be neat. And again, we'll click on colors and make some adjustments so I see multiple colors showing up. Because right now we're seeing lots of similar colors, but we'll just go ahead and alternate here. There we go. I'm clicking on those cells just to make them different here. Maybe go with that blue here, and then here I'll alternate. And then we'll click back on the text and we'll come back and turn on the shape again. And there we go. Now instead of this, we'll go with white. And there we go. So now we've got some additional cool looking backgrounds, make adjustments. And if you see here, I'll just shuffle through and now the background is changing up right there. And then when you're ready, you can just click on download and share these with your friends on social or anywhere else. And that's how you can create the mass text feature with colors in the background using Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video, drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. It helps YouTube share it with a larger audience. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.